and Caldwell 3. And we are about to go and witness a advanced screening of the film Red Lights up in Hollywood.
Hey everyone, hopefully we make it.
Yeah, hopefully we make it. We're in a little bit of traffic right now. We're actually almost there. It's going to be playing at the, we're just going to be playing at a theater in Hollywood. And, okay. And, we just met up. We're on our way to go check out this movie. Hopefully we're going to see the film and get a chance to talk about it.
We'll give you our thoughts on this movie.
Yeah, give our thoughts.
Fingers. Robert De Niro, Sigourney Weaver, and Cillian Murphy.
There it goes again.
You can edit that.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. I think it'll be funny if we even keep some of it in. The film actually comes from the director of Buried, starring Ryan Reynolds, which came out in 2010, I believe. Or 9. Was it 2009 or 10?
Yeah, his name, I haven't read it.
Yeah, it's the same director, so we're really looking forward to checking it out, and then we'll give you some of our thoughts and opinions about the film. So we'll see you in a few hours.
Go ahead, hit it.
Okay. All right, we just got out of seeing Red Lights, starring Sigourney Weaver, Robert De Niro, and Cillian Murphy.
Elizabeth Olsen.
And Elizabeth Olsen, the girl from Silent House. All right, so... the plot is basically Cillian Murphy and Sigourney Weaver are paranormal investigators. They're hardcore skeptics. And Robert De Niro plays this character who's like the world's top psychic, whatever, hoopla guy. So, we don't want to give away too many plot details, but go ahead, Chad.
This actually comes from the director of Buried, starring Ryan Reynolds. He's from Spain, and this is actually his third film and his second American film.
Yeah.
Even though it seems like he shoots everything in his native country.
Yeah, and one of the cool things about this movie was, I'm going to try not to let it influence my rating here on this movie, but they had a little panel after with Cillian Murphy showed up, and the director, Rodrigo Cortez, was here. So it was a big surprise for us. I thought it was just going to be an early screening, but cool little panel discussion after with those guys. So, and we got to meet Rodrigo. Cool guy, right? So
yeah.
He told us, he gave us approval to make a YouTube video about this. He said tweet about it, you know, talk about it. So we told him we make YouTube videos, and he didn't laugh. So that's
cool. Yeah, that's cool. He enjoyed, he's like, cool, promote the film. Please get it out there.
Exactly, yeah.
And I am glad, I just want to say right now, I am glad to help promote this film. Of course, review it. But I want to help promote this film. It comes out July 13th, Friday the 13th, or is that a Wednesday the 13th?
I think it's a Friday. Probably,
I don't know. I'm going to check.
Let me say something. Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead.
If you go into this movie expecting a hardcore horror movie, don't expect it. It's more of a psychological thriller, and it does kind of follow Buried like that. It's more about the psychology, and when we talked to him after, like he said, I want to make paranormal movies that are more realistic and these sorts of things. I mean, he was a really nice guy. But the movie, if you're expecting a hardcore horror movie, blood and guts, you're not going to get it.
Smarter than that.
Yeah, exactly, smarter. Really good performances. I thought Cillian Murphy, which I always thought was Cillian Murphy till today, but it's Cillian Murphy.
Cillian Murphy.
And he, I mean, knocked it out of the park. He had an awesome performance in this movie. What do you think?
I'm glad it wasn't a straight horror. Again, I had no idea what I was getting into. All I knew that it was the director of Buried. It had all these actors in the film. Toby Jones is also in it. It had all these actors in the film, and that's all I really know. I hadn't seen a trailer. I'd seen the poster. Didn't read any reviews. Had no idea what I was going to get into. So I had no expectations. I was just hoping that, hey, this guy made Buried, and I really liked that that movie. It's all centered in one location, but can he make a movie that actually spans out to more settings and locations and all that stuff? And I was really pleasantly surprised with this film. I think it's really great, and it's a movie that I'm going to see again when it comes out July 13th. Friday!
I think you could probably stand to watch it again. There might be a few things missed, and Rodrigo also tuned the thing. One problem I did kind of have with the movie was the editing a little bit, and he kind of alluded to that in the panel discussion.
he edited himself.
Yeah, he wrote, edited, and directed it, and like he said, you know, I screw the writer when I'm directing. When I'm editing, I screw the director. And when he said nobody stops the editor, though, so
yeah.
That was the problem. And
the
producer. Think he kind of realized it.
The producer.
Yeah, and I think it was, like I said, not a hardcore horror movie. I thought it was pretty good in general. All the performances are strong. I really liked the young Robert De Niro, the one scene they had.
Yeah, it was kind of weird for me.
I don't want to give any spoilers. It was kind of creepy and cool, and I really liked that. And I give, 1 to 5 stars. I'm going to give it a 3.5 out of
3.5.
I thought the ending was really good, and Cillian Murphy's performance, I mean, he's always good, but it was really strong, yeah.
I liked everybody's performance in this film. Elizabeth Olsen, very small, but she had a nice convincing performance, and also Toby Jones. But for me, I think it's Robert De Niro gets the shine, and so does Sigourney Weaver and Cillian Murphy.
Yeah.
They just have an opportunity to really get to know them as characters, and I don't know right now how happy I am with the ending, but what I will say is the movie I'm going to see again, but I was continually interested throughout the whole piece. I was never bored.
Definitely.
I was really invested, and everything was really good about the film, the direction and the cinematography. It looked really gritty, and the whole time I thought they were filming it in the United States. And no, it turns out, where's it at?
Barcelona, yeah.
Yeah,
I was wondering that when I was watching it.
What city is this?
Yeah, I mean, but like I said, you went in blind. I had seen the trailer. I was surprised. It wasn't exactly what I was thinking. You know, good movie though. I thought overall it was a good movie. Yeah. I don't know, like I said, if I would make a super strong recommendation. If you're a Cillian Murphy fan, watch it. Or if you like Buried, definitely you're gonna like it. I think.
And I'm gonna say if you just really
I like the ending better than you.
I think is gonna grow. I'm right now. I'm just trying to soak it all in. But what I will say is that it's a movie that really asks you to pay attention.
Yeah.
And I like that. I appreciate it. It actually felt like they cared that I was there.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And it did also help that we got to meet the director and afterwards and got to talk to him and get his approval and he was really thankful. I enjoyed the film, so I was really glad to get to meet the director of the film, and I look forward to his next film.
Yeah, and at the end of the panel discussion, it was kind of funny because I thought it was kind of like karma, although I don't believe in this stuff. But the last question the person asked, this is a minor spoiler. This is nothing. Cillian Murphy in the movie, he can spin the quarter through his fingers, you know, like a poker player or whatever. And the girl asked him, that was the final question of the panel, how did he learn how to do that? And he said he went on YouTube and he did a really good impression of a 11-year-old on YouTube, and it was pretty funny. I thought
how he found out about it.
Yeah,
know?
Total karma that we're going to do a YouTube video. And the last question was about, you know, he was kind of maybe making a little fun of YouTube, but cool, man. It was cool.
So again, with your final rating of the film?
3.5 out of 5, mostly because Cillian Murphy's performance in the ending.
Well, it was great because he definitely was the star of the show.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a really good movie. I don't know how big of the release it's going to get, but if you can find it in a theater near you, please go check out Red Lights. I'm going to give it 3.5 out of 4 stars.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I really, really enjoyed it.
Good.
And I hope to see it again and pay for it this time. And I suggest that you go and pay for it as well and check it out on July 13th.
Right, yeah.
Before I go, I just want to recommend that if you're watching this on my channel, please subscribe to this man.
Okay,
he's a great guy. Yeah. He invited me to this.
Okay.
And I really appreciate it. So please subscribe to Caldwell 3. I'll put this in the description box. I'm also in my trailer, and in my video, hopefully this will be your video too. Yeah. I'm going to put the trailer in the description box as well.
Yeah, me too, yeah.
So you can check out what this movie looks like.
Okay, well, let me... You might want to go in blind like Chad, so you might not want to watch the trailer.
Maybe
you liked it more than me. I still liked it. Like I said, not a complete horror movie, but definitely check out Movie Man Chad's channel. I haven't seen a movie in the theater before it came out since Tombstone, and you guys are all probably too young to remember that.
Yeah, mine was like Chernobyl Diaries.
Okay. Well, that was like a week ago.
I'm going to have to edit that out. Hey, Mom, I didn't say that. He said it.
Okay. I was going to say... The first person I invited was Movie Man Chad, so after like 20 years since Tombstone came out, I invited Movie Man Chad because, you know, he's a movie lover and I really appreciate it. So hopefully I'll get to more advanced screenings.
Yeah.
Till then, I guess I'll see you.
All right, dude. Thanks for inviting me.
Check out We Live Film, right?
Yeah.
Also,
subscribe to We Live Film and check it out at welivefilm.com. Yeah. Bye.
Right. See you guys. Bye. Came out pretty good, you think?
I sure hope so.
Okay.
Edit that out now.